refer to. I love your lips, my cousin, your lack of perfume.
Oh! To get you home, a curfew. Hello! You know, I often hear from strangers and friends alike, Ashley, you're a bit of an eccentric. Please, sister, tell me something I don't know. But as an accepted eccentric, I have no problem with people saying these things to me. I know deep down when they're saying, you're eccentric, what they're actually saying is, hey, you're weird as fuck. Did you know this? Because I'm gonna say this in a really passive-aggressive, mildly complimentary way, when in actuality I'm kind of being a douchebag. I'm weird, and I have absolutely no problem with that. I've accepted who I am, and so when people tell me I'm weird or bizarre, it's not really anything new to me. So I'll take it. Try to break me down. I'm a Tom Bearcat. That's a bear cat named Tom. See, when you think on your toes, you just kind of have to commit to things. And a Tom Bearcat would be such a commitment. Anyways, most recently I performed at my place of work, Riot Act Comedy Theater in Washington, D.C. It's a brand new comedy establishment, and it was my first really big performance. Sure, it was still an open mic and I didn't get paid, but people had to pay to get in, and that counts for something. And the food that's served there is really classy, so that also adds to the overall class factor. I'm sorry, I've got like stray little pubes in my hair. Do you see that? That's my spit and some hair. It's really gross. Well, glad I shared that with you. Anyways, the performance went okay. I got some hearty laughs, but it could have been better. What I learned from this experience was that I can go and take these nuggets, these rocks, these mineral deposits of comedy, if you will, and tumble them around and turn them into polished gems, and then take those polished gems and put them together and make a solid comedy set. That was the suggestion that I got from most comics that I had spoken with, was Ashley, take your solid material and make it funnier! Take it to the next level! They didn't actually do those hand motions, I did them in my head for them, because I'm sure for emphasis' sake, they really did explain a lot. Anyways, so I took that lesson, even though inside, I didn't feel like I was ready. I'm not exactly sure who I am, but I know myself well enough that sometimes I cannot, absolutely cannot, rush a process. Finding my voice in comedy is one such process. I realized that after this week, I'm limiting myself by sticking with just venting about being a lesbian because, oh, woe is me, it's so hard looking like a heterosexual girl in a gay world. But that's not really even the only thing I talk about, but just go with it, so I'm gonna stop doing this voice now. Anyways, I realize that sometimes the most direct path or the way that everybody else does things doesn't exactly work for me. A point further illustrated by this fun video of me flying a kite with my girlfriend after Hurricane Irene decimated the Washington, D.C. area. I'm also saying decimate as hyperbole because we got a lot of rain, huh? And a couple of gusts of wind. Okay, that's being kind of understating because some people did have other devastation. Okay, cut to the kites, please.
Kite was not actually in working order. We made do. You'll see here we have fashioned a stick in here to make this kite work.
So now it's time to see this sucker fly.
There's nothing to wear. I believe I can fly. I believe I can touch the sky. Think about it. Spread my wings and fly away. I believe I can soar. I see me running through that open door. I believe I can fly. I believe I can fly.
Fly, that was a bad idea!
Yeah, that was a bad idea! Yeah, that was a bad idea!
Ah, oh,
That was awesome.
I believe I can fly.
So flying a broken kite doesn't actually work out as well as planned. But as you can see here, other people have joined the fun and have brought their slightly more successful kites. But you know what the bigger lesson is? It doesn't matter if your kite is broken or your kite fucking sucks. All that matters is that you try to throw it up into the wind. You give it your best, because you'd be surprised at what would happen when you just throw it up there and don't give a fuck.
You hear that, world? Throw it up in the air. Just don't give a fuck. Yep. I'm gonna try again. And I'm gonna take to the stage, but this time I'm going to take some lessons with me. I realize that I can't rush a process. I need to stay true to who I am. And that's an adorably awkward, dinosaur-loving weirdo. I need to remember that. I'm more than just a lesbian. Like you, I'm human. A human who loves boobs. Very much. So what better place to take the stage than the literal boobtopia, both bound and broad?
The East Coast largest queer arts and music festival.
PHASFEST.
PHASFEST 2011.
To all my fellow weirdos out there, fear not, little friend, for you've got me on your squad. And that's not really much of a consolation, but at least you're not alone. Cue Michael Jackson. You are not alone. Yeah, I am here with you. And though you're far away, forever here. Motherfucker!
Right on the tip.